Good morning. I hope you are fine. So today I'd like to share with you a word about unity and identity. Scripture written today from the Gospel of St. John, chapter 17, from verses 20 to 26. Jesus is saying his last prayers. He's at the scene of the Last Supper with the apostles, and he raises his eyes to heaven and prays God that they may be one as you and I are one. In the first reading, which is taken from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 22, verses 30, and then chapter 23, from verses 6 to 11, Paul is before the Sanhedrin and he's able to manipulate his way out of trouble. So I'd like to say this morning a few things about unity and identity. In the Gospel reading, we find that the last wish of Jesus was that we be united. The unity of Christians is such an important matter in the heart of Jesus. So we have to take it a little bit more seriously, working for the unity of all who believe in Jesus. But that's not only for Christians. Even in the world as a whole, it's important that we work with one another. We cannot go it alone. It's very, very important. It was so important that it was the last thing that Jesus prayed for. So let us remember this morning, the first thing I'd like us to remember is that unity is not an option. Unity is not something we can joke with. Being united is something we really, really have to work at. Second thing I'd like to say is that unity is not only about the church or about organizations. We also need personal unity, the integrity of our identities. Each one of us is a number of many different things. You are a man, you are a worker, you're a teacher, you're so many different things. But it's important to be able to harmonize all of those identities that we have into an integral human being. That's what integrity means. So St. Paul this morning in the first reading, he was a Roman, he was a Jew, he was a Pharisee, and he was now a Christian. So he had all of these identities, and then he's brought before the Sanhedrin. The Sanhedrin was made up of Pharisees and Sadducees, two different identities. But what they had forgotten to do in the Sanhedrin was to unite as members of the Supreme Council. They were still playing their different identity cards. These ones would say, well, we are Sadducees, we don't believe in the resurrection, we don't believe in angels, we don't believe in spirits. And then Pharisees would say, well, we are members of the Supreme Council, but we still want to hold on to our identity. We are Pharisees and we believe in all of that. So Paul comes in this morning and he realizes that the group was divided. So what does he do? He says to the Pharisees, I am a Pharisee myself, and it is for the hope we all share in the resurrection that I'm being persecuted. And then the Pharisees turned against the Sadducees, and the group destroyed itself. So first of all, what I'd like to underline there is that Paul was able to integrate all of his identities, his Jewish identity, his Pharisee identity, and his Christian identity to get what he wanted. So it's important for us to have integrity, to integrate all of our identities. The third and the final thing I'd like to say about that is that unless we integrate our identities, unless we unite, we are going to be very easy to destroy. Now see what Paul does this morning. See what Paul does with the Pharisees and the Sadducees. He was able to, you know, pitch them against themselves. Child of God, the truth is an external enemy doesn't really need to have all the energy to fight you. All he needs to do is to divide you into camps, and then you will fight yourselves. It is the same principle for the church. The devil doesn't need to come and destroy the church. All he needs to do is to set members within the church against other members in the church. He doesn't need to destroy families. All he needs to do is to set family members against family members. He doesn't really need to come and destroy nations. All he needs to do is to set some members of that same nation against other members of the same nation. So that's why it is very important for Jesus this morning that we become united. But as we work towards unity, let us know that the unity that Jesus prayed for is not the same as fusion. He says, let them be one as you, Father, and I are one. So what he calls us to do is harmony, not fusion. Because as the philosopher of Schopenhauer would say, the first path, the first step towards happiness is to accept to be who we are. So we must keep who we truly are, preserve our identities while we work for the unity of the entire group. May Almighty God bless you this morning, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.